For more than a century, clinicians have pondered the significance of elevated blood pressure and its contribution to cardiovascular risk. But the most appropriate BP goal continues to be a subject of debate still. Before entering into the core of the discussion, I would like to point out that despite the high prevalence of hypertension and the damage it causes, the most important problem we as Indians face, the lack of diagnosis, the high percentage of people that do not know that they are hypertensive, and in treatment of hypertension, there is a scarce degree of its control. So this linear relationship, Dr. Mukesh has already, the value of 40 by 90 was obtained in a conventional manner, and so far the evidence showed no benefit in treating patients with antihypertensive drugs in the intermediate range, that is between 115 by 75 and 140 by 90. So you should take hypertension, it's rarely an isolated risk factor. So other risk factors like diabetes, dyslipidemia, smoking and all has to be considered when you are treating a patient with hypertension. So goal is therefore not very straightforward. The issue is further complicated by the evidences of recent trials. And so is there a need to go low is the question. The J curve, also discussed by Dr. Mukesh, is a paradoxical increase in the cardiovascular mortality. We should not forget the basics of physiology, which is shown by J curve, and the perfusion, which is affected in the range of low blood pressure. Not only heart is affected, we should consider brain and kidney perfusions when we think of low blood pressures. So there is a general consensus to reduce the blood pressure in the hypertension population to values below 140 by 90. However, in special populations such as diabetes, CKD and elderly people, there are discrepancies among the different guidelines in relation to therapeutic targets. So multitude guidelines are there from respected professional bodies and individuals have caused, in my opinion, needless confusion bordering on chaos. So this JNC7, JNC8, ACCHA targets you all know. The controversial JNC8 relaxed the blood pressure goals for elderly from 140 by 90 to 150 by 90. On one hand, while JNC8 guidelines relaxed the targets in elderly, the sprint is trying to reduce it. So these are all the controversies going on. ACCORD trial compared intensive therapy group with standard therapy group, and at the end of 5 years, this did not document a significant reduction in the primary outcome with the lower BP goals. The SPS3 trial also didn't show any significant benefit in lowering the blood pressure levels to less than 130. So additional fuel to the fire has recently been added by this sprint trial. The details already told. So what should be the goal of blood pressure? Should you target hypertensives to very low blood pressure goals? I wonder what went wrong suddenly. Are we not happy with the standard goals? How can we forget the J-curve phenomena? Why there is a need to create this controversy or confusion? And sprint trial has separated hypertensive patients with diabetic patients, which we see in our day-to-day practice. So whether to go low, so low, I don't think we need to go so low. How low should we go to reduce the cardiovascular risk? We may lose our balance and may fall there. So amongst the hypertension patients, diabetes is approximately 80% seen. And which target will we win in diabetes, whether it is sprint or ACCORD? So several considerations and questions regarding the results of sprint trial I need to stress. First is the adverse events which were seen in the sprint trial. The occurrence of serious adverse events in the group of most sensitive treatment, most intensive treatment was seen, such as the occurrence of syncope, sustained hypotension, electrolyte abnormalities, and acute renal damage was common. So these adverse effects have an impact, at least in the real world, on adherence of treatment. So these adverse outcomes of the sprint should not be overlooked lightly. Second thing is diabetes, stroke patients, and elderly people were excluded from this trial. And so the target population limited if you consider our day-to-day patient population. Third is the technique of BP measurement. The sprint protocol does not address the issue of staff attendance, nor have the investigators yet published the information on this topic. However, to fully realize the benefits and minimize the risk we should give stress on the use of automated BP devices, the staff training to allow for a quiet rest period, proper positioning, proper cuff size has to be thought instead of giving importance to the BP measurement in presence of attendant or unattended. The next thing is the at the end of the study, systolic blood pressure was 136/0.4 in the standard group and 121.5 in the intensive group. So to achieve this, the patients patient receives more than two antihypertensive drugs, and we cannot extrapolate BP values from the sprint study to our daily practice. The potential issues are increased cost of medications, increased risk of medications, side effects, increased clinical visits, increased monitoring required in such patients, and the risk already I have. So there is no significant reduction in MI and stroke as seen in this study, and there were few improvement in patient with heart failure that was attributed to use of diuretics as an antihypertensive drug. So why the debate? Let's achieve the standard goal first. And after all the hype and hoopla, it is doubtful that the sprint trial will really have a significant impact on our clinical practice, and it will not revolutionize the blood pressure treatment. In the recent ESC meeting, there was a response of audience vote which was asked, and this was the response which they got. Thumbs down, and see that one person is raising both his hands up. So I raise caution at the moment of generalizing the results of clinical trials to the patients of real world and go low or no. So we need not go that low is my opinion in this. Thank you.